Hello, my friends. With the new Black Panther film on the horizon, I thought it's a good time to look at some Black Panther concept art. We're specifically looking at art from the first Black Panther film and how it imagines the architecture of Wakanda. I actually considered doing this video a long time ago, but for various reasons, I never got around to it. Until now. We'll start by looking at the background, which has a handful of buildings inspired by Sudano-Sahelian architecture. This term, Sudano-Sahelian architecture, broadly refers to a kind of mud brick architectural style that can be found in the upper half of West Africa. There's at least two specific Sudano-Sahelian buildings that seem to be referenced in this cityscape. The first one being this tall cylindrical structure here, which appears to be based on a minaret belonging to the Grand Mosque of Bani. And again, this is only part of the mosque. Here's a look at the front of the building so that you can see the mosque in full. This house of worship can be found in the country of Burkina Faso. If you look this thing up online, it may look a little different both in terms of height and appearance for two reasons. One is that some of the photos are taken on top of the roof of the mosque, which cuts the towering appearance of this thing in half, but also because that when it comes to mud brick buildings, they require periodic maintenance, and after being eroded from the rainy seasons, it needs to be repaired from time to time. So yeah, that's why the look of this thing can change. In fact, if you look in the background of this image, you can see a group of architects replastering another part of the structure. The other Sudano-Sahelian building being directly referenced in Wakanda's concept art is the Great Mosque of Djenné, which resides in the country of Mali. It happens to be the most famous example of this architectural style, and if you want to learn more about it, you can check out a video I made specifically about Djenné and the architects who help maintain this historical architecture. And before we move on, I want to mention that I recall someone in a documentary once saying that the Great Mosque looks like something out of a sci-fi movie. Well, interestingly enough, the Black Panther movie is not the only sci-fi film to reference this architecture, and I may make a video about the various references to Africa in that particular sci-fi film sometime in the future. Now let's move on to the left side of this artwork, where we see these round roofed buildings. These are almost certainly inspired by a very old Amazigh structure in Libya, known as Qasr al-Hajj. It is an ancient fortification which was used to store and protect food, such as dates, figs, oil, wheat, and barley. Below this Libyan-inspired architecture, you may also notice a smattering of walls painted with triangle patterns. There are actually a number of different African peoples who painted their homes with various designs and intricate patterns. The one that we're looking at here feels reminiscent of the patterns one can see on Nankani homes. The Nankani live on the border of Burkina Faso and Ghana. The men construct the basic structure of the Nankani homes, and then the women decorate the houses with various details and patterns. Not only are these Nankani compounds aesthetically beautiful, but they are also built for defense against attackers. Lastly, in the corner here we have a round hut, which frankly could be reflective of a lot of different African dwellings since it's a pretty standard design. Now, as I'm sure you've noticed, a lot of what is in this image didn't make it into the final film, but that's the point of concept art. It helps creators to decide what works and what doesn't work for their projects. I, for one, am glad that they didn't include this whole glass enclosure thing they wrapped around all the traditional buildings in this concept, because in my opinion, this transparent enclosure makes the buildings look like they're covered in a museum glass case, you know? As if they're just there for show instead of being a real living space. As far as what was included in the final version of the Black Panther film, I personally think that they could have pushed the African aesthetics further, but overall, they did a good job inserting African art and culture into the superhero genre of film. Now, as of the recording of this video, the second film, Black Panther Wakanda Forever, is not yet out, so I don't have much yet to say about how it handles the African cultural imagery. But what I can say from looking at the trailers is that the focus of the new film seems to be more geared toward exploring the culture and homeland of the antagonist, known as Namor, whose country is inspired by Mesoamerican culture. I happen to find the native cultures of America interesting as well, so I might dig into that stuff if we analyze the new Black Panther film. But just keep in mind that I said I might do that. Either way, I will likely do a video about the sequel film eventually. For the first Black Panther film, I did a review, but I might just stick to doing just cultural analyses like this one for the new film, because anyone can do a review video, but not many people can actually recognize and analyze the art and culture like I can. But anyway, we'll see how that all works itself out. None of these plans are set in stone, I'm just sort of thinking out loud here. And I also want to point out that there's still some stuff in the original Black Panther film, beyond what we just talked about and what we've talked about in the past, that I still kind of want to make a video about. Having said all that, I hope you enjoyed this video, and look forward to more Black Panther content in the future. And please, remember to subscribe so you don't miss out on our videos. Thank you for watching.